Hello, I'm just about to show you the concept of adverse cycle input. So in War Thunder, when you put your stick forward, the helicopter roll a bit to the side. This is BeamNG, where everything is physically simulated. The aerodynamics are kind of primitive in this game, but the stuff like gyroscopic precession effects, all that stuff, all the complicated stuff that goes along with it, are simulated in this game. This is actually a mod of Darren Nine's DH Super Gnat. I've worked on it for the past month and a half or so. I made things a bit more realistic. For example, the blades are no longer super rigid. So if I respawn the helicopter, you can see they wobble a bit. They actually got a bit of play in them to simulate not so. So, you know, rotor flapping, all that sort of stuff. And something like that I found with rotor flapping, like with less rigid rotors, is that you get adverse cyclic input as well. So, if I just increase the engine RPM, the thing is not well balanced right now, because it is still kind of like, it's hard to get things to work well in BeamNG because everything is like physically simulated, and there's like certain rounding issues because the physics runs at 1,000 times per second. You get to erase more numbers, things can go a bit wonky, and dampening values tend to like either cause your vehicle to explode or do something strange rather than actually doing the intention of dampening vibrations. And so there's a lot of hard play in balancing these forces when you're making these physical models. Anyway, so I'll show you. So this is going to be pitch forward. You'll notice the rotor will actually tilt to the side a bit. Roll directly to left, you can see also like it tilts forward a bit. But roll to right, you'll see it tilts back and actually almost hits the tail. Oop, I guess that time. And if I pitch back, it will obviously hit the tail, because that's just how I've configured the helicopter right now. See if I pitch that all the way. This is technically a low quality model because there's only the middle section and the end section. Actually, this entire thing, the entire blade, is just only one piece, and then there's this reinforcement spar in the middle. Due to the way it's been modeled, there's a lot of limitations, and I had to fix a blade torsioning issue where the blade twists at high speeds. That's also why the helicopter flies extremely well upside down but not upright. With this mod, it's now it's both terrible in both directions, although you can configure the blade twist manually. But the reason why it flies so terrible now is because I've actually got realistic aerodynamic values in it, because before there was values of like two to three times what you'd find in real life. So anyway, so we'll go flying. This realistic configuration requires a lot of anti-torque. If I go full left, that tail actually stalls. So it's actually kind of finicky to fly. I don't think many people find this that enjoyable, which is why I left the original rotors in place. But this is definitely the more realistic side now. It's just the currently the rotors are called realistic low drag lift tunable tail rotor, and then the other one is experimental rotor, realistic lift and drag testing. So as you got those two, and perhaps you can get the let me switch this to the strong experiment upper frame. This is the configuration you want for like realistic physics and stuff. The reason why is that because there's actually a lower mounting point for the blades at the top, because the Ocean one has it really, really high up. Anyway, so what I was going to say is I was going to demonstrate the adverse cyclic effects while flying. So despite how much adverse cycling there is while on the ground, when you're actually flying, you don't really feel it so much. Which probably explains why DCS doesn't even bother to model again, like, at all. so if I go full pitch forward, actually I probably won't do that because it will probably destroy the tail, but this is pitch up, pitch down. You can see it's not really rolling that much. So I pitched a bit too much just now. So that oscillation you got just now, you saw, is because the rotor was actually stolen. Is the rotor is actually that sensitive. So the pitch range is roughly this much. Actually, it's hard to see from this angle. So roll left, roll right. You can see that's how much the blade pitches. So it is pretty aggressive, actually. Let me show you again. So this is full collective, and I'll roll left. You can see that's clearly a stall angle attack. So I've actually got a special loadout for new people to try. If they find these two too hard, there's this trainer configuration which I just created like today. Or yesterday, because it's 4:50 in the morning, and it dampens the input a bit, quite a fair bit actually, and it should help if that's all from. Anyway, so so back to this, you can see that the while on the ground there is quite a lot of adverse cyclic input. The left, it pitches for like maybe national 20 degrees, 30 degrees. Backwards, likewise. It just barely misses the tail. Anyway, so let me get some speed so I can conk myself in the stall. So I just lost the tail authorities, now I stopped my tail. So this should be fast enough. I'm just gonna go full hard left. So it's the rotor kind of stalled there as well. I might have to reduce collective when I do it. So, like this. So this model is very unresponsive compared to like the vanilla rotors, because like I said, the generates like half to a third of the actual lift that the previous rotors did. So this can't fly, you know, 400 kilometers per hour like the other ones did. It's kind of hard to tell, but there is a bit of a lift going left, and lift going right, and there's a bit of a dip going left. So I'll show you again. So the direction of adverse control, I've noticed, is a bit kind of opposite when you're actually flying. So when the greatest chance to actually strike the tail is not when you're pitching up, it's actually when you're pitching down. So if I go full pitch up, so it didn't hit the tail, you can see. Mm-hmm. The funny thing is, despite how much anti-torque authority I need, I've actually specifically tuned this helicopter to be like it will hover at 50% rudder. So as you can see, it's actually well balanced. It's just that like the tail authority is just so ineffective, and even still, I gave it quite like a substantial amount. So the lift coefficient for the main rotors is actually like basically 1.38. It's actually 138, but it's like it's basically percentage, so you just divide by 100, and then the tail rotors are 150. But this is not taking into account the fact that so like I said, the aerodynamics in this came out primitive. So if I were to go third person view, in real life, the rotors would actually spin the tail rotor would actually spin this way rather than forwards, and this gets you an additional force going this way. But the problem of doing that way is that it generates a lot of noise and a lot of vibrations, and it can be unsettling. But yeah, you can see it's under the rotor wash of the main rotor. In real life, the tail rotor is actually usually at least like maybe like the center point is, well, not under the wingspan of the main rotor. This is just like I said, this is a fictional helicopter, kinda similar to the real life. I think it's a Mosquito. It's also a tripod, but did not have a massive swash plate like this with little tiny gimpy arms, you know. But anyway, also had a much smaller engine on this engine is fucking massive. It's a fucking two-cylinder massive engine. So I'll show you. So pitch forward. I won't go all the way. I'll pitch for a little bit, and you can see the rotor gets a bit closer as I pitch up. The rotor actually gets away from the tail. So it's a little something interesting to note. So I actually didn't think this was going to happen. This is where I was wrong, because the way I thought it would happen is like because when you pitch forward, so let me just restart. When you pitch forward, this blade actually pushes the air backwards. As you can see, this is full collective. It pushes the air backwards, so it actually pulls the front forward. And because it's drag on the fuselage, it swings it back. When you pull it back, the drag increases on the other side, which is the foregoing blade, and pulls this thing back. But for some reason, the opposite ends up happening, and as a result, the adverse cyclic is also kind of like the opposite of what you expect. So, like, you know, on the ground, if I pitch forward, you can see the rotor pitches forward and to the right. The pitching to the right, I think, is just because the cyclic's actually, like, you know, mounted that way. If I mounted the cyclic in reverse, where, like, say, I show you in slow motion, the cyclic actually, the way it works is that it pushes on the front, the leading edge of the blade, and because that's just also how it works, there's also a bunch of other, like, physics-related issues with how the controls work when I'm trying to fine-tune it, because you can get swash plate oscillation, an entire thing just like vibrates like crazy. The blades will tend to like fishtail, and it's just, I don't know. Trying to tune this helicopter to get this realistic behavior is a mess, and I don't know. I mean, like, that's just how it works in BeamNG. You don't, it's not like other sims where you just program behavior. Like, when the car's turning, like, to the left, you need to impart a force that makes the wheel roll to the right a bit and exert a bit of pressure. No, the game engine just does that for you. in this. And the amount of force it exerts depends on how heavy the nodes are. And I should get along about how, I should talk about how the restrictions of the nodes, like with the physics system, because earlier when I said that the damping system, like, you put a damping value too high, the thing just kind of explodes and implodes. You know, I'll just show you an example right now. Say if I rip off a blade. Nothing too funky right now, because I've kind of tuned it. But if I were to go in here and now turn up, where is it? This one. I've made a description makes it a helicopter appear possessed. I'll just turn it to like 190, see what happens. So I'll rip off a blade and we'll see what happens. And we'll just start wiggling on its own. So this, you can see this blade is like angled like this. That's because it's a prop, it's not a physical, like the model is not a physical object. It's not a, what do you call a flex body. So you look at this tail, this is a flex body, it's actually bound to the nodes. But the, like I said earlier, the blades are actually simplified into M pieces with a reinforcement spar in the middle. You can see it's bouncing. The reason why I think the original creator did that is because the limitations of how hard it is to tune the helicopter. Like, this, the fact that the helicopter rotors break off with the slightest bit of roll already is, like, showing you how much on the verge of limits the physics are, because the amount of forces going through the rotors. I mean, like, I can't even get the rotors to spin off above. Let me get this console back up. Actually, let me undo that change. Technically, you don't actually need any damping. I don't know why I put some in there. So if I get the console back up, then you can see the miles per hour. Stuff. So there's a, you can see there's a, whoops, there's an engine RPM and then there's a rotor. So the way it works is that there's a centrifugal clutch, kind of like in a moped. You go above a certain speed, it spins up the other one. But if, however, if you cut the engine, it allows the rotor to continue spinning. So if there's an emergency where your engine dies, you can still basically glide to it. Anyway, so this is bouncy. It's really hard to like dampen this weird vibration. Actually, why is it even? It's not even letting me fucking do this anymore. I guess I do need a I guess I do need this. Hang on. What is it? I probably do need it. So see what happens if I just put it back to 50. You see what I mean? So like that fucking weird change that does almost nothing, that makes a helicopter appear possessed, fix that vibration to death issue. So this is the thing. This is one of those things that I'm talking about when like this is trying to balance these values. Is it's a very tight margin. Anyway, so back to this. This rate RPM, once it reaches about 4800, 4900, it just explodes, no matter what you do. Even in the vanilla, like, model, if you get up to, like, 5500, which is really high, but it's really super sturdy, it'll still explode. And the original model had a lot of infinitely strong values as well. And this helicopter, the way of, like, the realistic configuration, it's actually very unstable between, like, hang on, somewhere like 1500, yeah, 1500 all the way to like 3000 ish, and after that it kind of like stabilizes. Like if I just let go of the throttle, like let it slow down, usually this will be fairly stable, but it will start wobbling again. Can see the wobbles get worse. It's like the resonant frequency is of the chassis is around there, and one does not simply tune the resonant frequency of a physics body. So like in DCS, I had to fake the instrument panels shaking, and then like I made comments in Reddit and shit about saying the instrument panel shakes that much, I'd be scared that it's gonna fucking fall off this thing. Well, you can actually fucking rip off the instrument panel if you try hard enough. Yeah, so that's just this is, you don't have to fake that shit in this game. It just happens. The instrument panel will fall off on its own. So let's see if I just slam on the ground. Funny, I think I reinforced it. I definitely reinforced it from the original model, because the original model was just like, it just fell off way too easily, but now it's like, because of rotors, it's the first thing that falls off now with the realistic rotors, it's just like, it is still connected. It's not even bent. How hard do I have to crash this to actually get the fucking console off? So like, there's material values you can look up, but the problem is like, they're not gonna be that useful because you can't have very small angles. Like, you see this angle here? The higher this is, the more stable it is. But that's the way the rotor's mounted, is that you have the tips mounted to this point here, somewhere in the middle and somewhere in the bottom. But I made it so like, with the rotor configuration, the outer edge linkages are very weak, and they're just there to dampen the flopping motion, because if I don't, it's gonna flop too much. The blade strength between the tip to the root is extremely strong, and these are these little floating bits here, they're their stiffness. It looks like it says a triangle truss. This tail has a lot of reinforcement nodes, because it just wants to fall off. I did a bit of hacker here, so the aerodynamics is actually, this is a flat piece. I'll to go debug. I think the rendering might be still fucked. Did it get fixed? Nah, it's still bugged. So there's a bug with the rendering engine where the aerodynamic surface, they're supposed to be like pink and green on either side, but they rendering kind of screwed that up. So if I turn off the model rendering, this is the actual aerodynamic model, so I'll slow it down. The way you see the rotors work is that there's actually a cross-sectional triangle, and then there's the two main triangles going across the surface, which forms a rectangle. It's actually very nice that he did it this way, because he can do physics for the inner blade portion as well as outer blade portion. And the way the aerodynamics are applied in this game is that they are applied to every node in the vision, not just through center of the triangle. And then the forces are summed up on each node. And so it's simplified, but it's still at least, like for every surface, there's still at least three forces applied to along the triangle. So you see those blues, the lift vectors, the red is the drag. I'm not really sure what the yellow is. I think yellow just means there's a point there that has aerodynamics that can be applied, but it's not active, I think, something like that. And so yeah, you can see this red surface is actually flat-ish. I spent a few hours earlier trying to bend it, make it actually appear as close as possible and as flat as possible. As you can see, it's good enough. And then here's the stabilizer, which actually adds lift. In real life, you actually have it pointing, so like it generates negative lift, but that makes no sense for me in terms of stability standpoint, because you generally want it to push nose down rather than pull the nose up, because that just puts excessive pressure wastage on the blades and stuff, you know that. Helicopters are one of those things where having positive lift on the tail is actually probably more beneficial than negative lift. But if you really wanted to, you can just adjust this value here. So, you know, this is kind of what they have on like a fucking K50 or something. Gee. Oh, I need to fix that. So that is not, so this degrees thing is wrong because I did some trigonometry and it was for the old value when the head points over here. So this is, I need to fix that. And then this stabilizer angle, say if I go 0 degrees, you can see that's flat on. And if I go, let's turn this back to zero. And then if I go, you know, stabilize angle minus 20, that's full. It's still a bit wonky, because I kind of did a lazy job. I didn't do a tangent calculation that like I should have. I did it for the leading edge and for the the surface here with when the leading edge of the triangle is further forward, and then now to recalculate it, it's just like can't be asked now. So if I re-enable the model, you can see what I've done. So physically the node is pushed over here, but for the back ones, because they're brand new, I implemented them myself, they're mounted to like 5 points or something for rigidity, and then I've actually just straight up just pre-bent it. So if I just go refresh, you can see it starts off flat and then slowly bends itself inwards. It's a bit of a hacky method, but that's this is just the way you do it. If you bend it too quick, it's just going to snap everything off, because the damping effects gives things a bit of inertia, and then it kind of like go whoops. So I can show you, like for example with this, I can bend up, I can bend it down, like this. But if I slow down the physics to like super slow motion and I go 100% force, push up, push down. I think I already broke it. Yeah, it's already broken. So you can see the inertia plays a big role in the way physics work. You can't just, you know, bench it. Let's do it again. There's a radiator. And if I just do like slow motion. Well, I think this is actually properly stuck in. Well, I guess not. A little squishy. I probably should fix that. This is a physics game after all. BeamNG is kind of known as your car simulator, driving simulator, but it's actually also a crash simulator. This is one of the fun things of this game. But yeah, I don't play this game to drive cars. I play this game to fucking fly this. Ever since I got it. Thanks for listening to my absolutely random video that was originally going to be about, what, 1 or 2 minutes long. But, yeah, I made a speech about the complexities of fine-tuning aircraft in BeamNG, damage models. Oh fuck, where the f- here's OBS. I'm still not used to Fedora.